Hello everyone, this is Matthew Tucker. Welcome to another tutorial on the Bifrost Rigging Module series. In this video, we'll walk through a module's interface step by step. Now let's create a new Bifrost Rig graph. Do that by going up to Windows, Bifrost Graph Editor. Once that's open, we'll click Create Graph. Now that everything is created, let's do a quick overview of a Bifrost graph. Bifrost works from left to right. On the left is all the data that comes into your Bifrost graph. What happens in the middle is all the creation and behavior of your rigs. And the output is how the information is sent back to Maya. Now let's cover the ports. There are three main ports: the inputs, outputs, and parents. The inputs is all the data from the scene being sent into your module. The outputs is everything that happens in your scene being sent back out to Maya or even downstream modules. And the parents, if I make a quick one, establishes the relationship between a parent module and its child. Next is the general parameters. This helps define the behavior of a module. In order to see them, we'll go up to Windows, Parameter Editor. Now with the template module selected, we will see there's two main parameters, the name and the state. The name parameter, which defines the name of the module, can also be used inside the rig to generate naming conventions for both controls and joints. In order to demonstrate the state parameter, I have created a simple scene with a root module at the base and a variable FK chain. So if I select the variable FK, I see the state is set to animation. That means all transformations will happen on this module. But if I set it to rest relative, the transformations within the module itself will be disabled, but it will still inherit its parent's transformations. Finally, if I set it to rest absolute, it will no longer inherit any transformations whatsoever. Now to make a quick caveat, if I was to go into my Bifrost rig, go into attributes and unflatten the controls so everything was direct hierarchy, you can see the state is still set to rest absolute, but it will inherit its parent's transformations due to it being a direct hierarchy. When you need to start debugging your module, diagnostics can save you a ton of time. In order to turn on diagnostics mode, click the D at the bottom of your module. Once on, you can start activating different diagnostic modes. So let's first look at our pin orientations. Now we don't see them just yet because we also need to enable the display transforms. Once enabled, we have a few options for the shape of the transform. But first, let's scale up the transformations by left-clicking and sliding our mouse over. We can now clearly see the orientation of our pins. Now let's see our control orientations, and finally our joints. Once you are done using the diagnostic mode, just click the D at the bottom of the module again. Finally, if you ever want to know how well your module performs, just turn on profile evaluation. With that active, you can use Maya's profiler to see how optimized your module is. So with that active, we'll go to Windows, General Editors, Profiler. So let's start recording. I'll step forward a few frames and then stop. Once done, we are going to look for the Bifrost portion of the profiler. Let's select everything in here and hit F to focus. Now with that focused, we can see how fast our variable FK module is because the profile evaluation has been set to on. Now that should cover the basics for the Bifrost Rigging Modules interface. Thank you so much.